Okay, so we're live. So I believe you keep water for the dogs, right?
Yes, yeah.
And you fill this fountain every day?
This is
for them.
Whenever they get done, it's almost empty and I have to fill it back.
You have to fill it back. So when do they usually come to drink water?
It's there all the time. So I mean, in the night, most of the time it is there. If it's empty, they've had it in the night. So it's depending on the heat and everything. Okay. That's all up to their thing.
Right. So how long have you been keeping water for dogs?
It's been since March and I moved here.
Okay. Okay.
I used to have it in the other shop also.
Where was it?
That was in Vanavari.
Okay.
When I shifted here, has been there since then.
Right. So you run a pizzeria.
Yeah.
Pharaoh's Pizzeria. So we see heroes everywhere, and I believe you're in a rush. Yeah.
So, a little bit.
Yeah. Can you just introduce yourself a little bit?
So it's Dhruv. I run Pharaoh's Pizzeria, which is in Mohammedwadi. I've been doing this for 2 years. Uh-huh. And that's that. We have not set up yet.
Yeah.
In the evenings it's set. So that's the thing.
Right. So thank you for staying back. Okay. And we'll get back to you again later.
Thank you.
We have Dhruv over here who keeps water. But now these are the real heroes.
Hi.
So this is Ananya. Thank you so much, Dhruv.
Hi.
So Ananya, how old are you?
I'm 13 years old.
13.
Yes.
And this is your little doggy.
Yes. He's about 1.5 years old.
Okay.
Yeah. He is my hero because he literally has been, like, whenever I'm down and out or I'm upset, he's always been there for me. And that really means a lot because, you know, you always have, like, a friend next to you who's ready to cuddle whenever you want. So, yeah, that's nice.
But, Ananya, what I was really impressed about was what you did on your birthday.
Yes.
So, can you tell us what you did on your birthday?
So, it was my 13th birthday on the 12th of September. And, you know, I didn't want to be, like, you know, the traditional throw a birthday celebration and, you know, call my friends over because I just don't like that. I mean, it's fun and all, but
you can have that kind of fun anytime.
Yeah, and nobody really pays attention to friends. Nobody really pays attention to the real ones who actually are these ones.
Yeah.
And you know, they are not given most of the attention to, and they are usually just left because they don't have a voice. So what I decided to do was I took rotis, biscuits, and kibble, and I fed all of these all the way from cloud 9 all to here, and it's just really heartwarming, and you know, I just love doing things for them because it means a lot to them and it means a lot to me. So
so I believe you asked your mom to make 100 rotis.
Yes, I did.
So she made 100 rotis for you to feed all of them on your birthday. Lovely. You also do some rescue or first aid. So
basically any dogs that are hurt that I see, or I also visit the Blue Cross Society and donate, you know, Pune. Yeah, in Pune, the Blue Cross Society. It's a rescue center, if you don't already know, and they're quite good. They have like an infirmary and everything. So basically I just go there every weekend whenever I can. Or if there's like no school, but I just love doing things for these creatures because they're beautiful and we shouldn't really not pay attention to them.
Yeah, and I believe there was a dog that was injured. You're looking after him?
Yes, I am.
So what have you done?
So
he's wounded in his leg.
Yeah, he's hurt his leg, and I basically went to Murphy's vet, who's Dr. Sagar at Savitri Vihar, and I got an ointment. Because, I mean, it's hurt and anyone would really like to be cured, and there are no vets in and around this area, so it would be nice for someone to just help out.
Yeah, so if there's any injured dog, you are ready to do some first aid.
Absolutely,
and,
yeah.
And do you go to meet Dr. Sagar or work over there or intern over there?
Like,
I heard you do something
I
like
do,
that.
Yeah, so basically I started about a year ago when Dr. Sagar actually advised me that he needed an assistant, so I basically offered and agreed that okay, why not? I mean, I love animals, so why wouldn't I do it? So I did it, and then he has been giving me a remuneration, which I was hesitant to accept, but I mean, it's okay. And I've been I go there twice a week to assist. Whatever,
okay, And this is after school hours.
After school, yeah.
So that is wonderful. You're just 13 and you are so sensitized to these animals.
I am.
Wonderful. And here we have another hero, Bunch. Yes? So I'll ask you the questions, Bunch. So first tell me, how old are you?
Eight.
You're 8 years old, yes. And what do you do every day?
I feed my stray dogs.
You feed your stray dogs. I love that. So what do you give them?
Tiger biscuits.
Tiger biscuits. Wonderful. And are you also a little afraid of them?
No.
No. Not at all?
No.
Very good.
But he likes to love them.
He likes to love them.
Love them.
So this is Vansh's mom.
Hello.
Prachi.
Hello everyone. Hello auntie.
Hi. So it's so wonderful because I find that even though you are scared of dogs.
Much. I'm much scared of dogs.
You are still encouraging your son
to
be compassionate to animals around him. This is so beautiful.
Thank you. And I'm learning how to be compassionate to dogs from him actually.
Wow. So what made you feel that, okay, I should allow my son to be compassionate? What was it that
it was just the way he wanted to love the animals that I couldn't do. I always was scared of dogs, but he's just not scared of dogs and he wants to love them. So I just felt like I should let him go.
wonderful. So do you also feed them?
Yes, of course.
You feed them?
Yes, sometimes. The rotis and all, whatever is there, then I hand it over to Vansh and his father and they feed.
But you don't yourself?
No.
Because you're scared.
Yes, because I'm scared. But now I'm overcoming it slowly.
Wonderful.
And gradually.
Wonderful. So how long has Vansh been feeding these dogs?
Almost a year.
Almost one year.
Yes.
And he's named all the dogs as well.
Yes, he's named all of his stray dogs. And those are his friends.
Right. So Vansh, tell me all the names of all the dogs you have.
Jack.
Okay.
John.
Okay.
Don.
Don.
Rani.
Rani.
Jill.
Jill.
And Puffy.
Puffy. Wow. Wonderful. And do they all come running to you if you call them?
Yes.
Okay. And do they play with you?
Yes.
Okay. And what more do you want to do? If one of these dogs gets hurt, what will you do?
I'll put a bandage.
You'll put a bandage.
Yes,
wonderful.
He puts a bandage.
He does?
Yes, he does.
Okay.
He doesn't know how to do it, but he does it in his own way.
That's so beautiful. That is so heartwarming. So I just wanted to tell everybody that, I think there's so much to learn from you, Prachi. Because you
are scared.
Actually,
there's so much to learn from Vansh and kids like Ananya and you, auntie. I'm really grateful to have friends like you all around.
Yeah, we love you too. But what I'm saying is, it's so important for parents to allow compassion to grow in their children.
Of course.
That is something I think every parent should, learn.
Even though
you are scared of dogs, the fact that you're encouraging him to, develop that feeling
compassion.
Of compassion and empathy and care for dogs is so wonderful. Here you can see he's playing with Murphy.
He'll pass this on to the human beings. Once he learns to love animals, he'll love human beings too in the same way. That's the main thing.
That is so important. That is such
important.
A wonderful message. And so everybody, I think let's give a hip hip hooray for these kids.
Hip hip
hooray.
Hip hip
hooray. Hip hip
hooray.
So Ananya, you are already also on the group now.
Yes,
your mom said that we should add you.
Yes.
That is wonderful. And I just mentioned that we would want to go to the PMC because the stray dogs here aren't sterilized.
Yes.
And your immediate response was?
I would like to come.
So Ananya is going to accompany me to the PMC to meet Dr. Sabne here, who is in charge of the ABC, to make sure, that is ABC means animal birth control, to make sure that the dogs here get sterilized, because otherwise
fights break out and it's not pretty.
Yeah, there are a lot of fights in the night, there's a lot of barking and a lot of disturbance. Because it's the mating season.
Yeah.
And that's the reason they're getting injured.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and I think it's just not right that we're paying taxes and the PMC is not doing its job.
Right.
Because there are people here who are paying out of their pocket, sending the dogs to CCC and You know, it's just not possible to get so many dogs sterilized in a short period of time.
Yes.
When actually the PMC has set aside funds. Has a budget for the ABC.
They claim.
They claim, yes. And actually Blue Cross is supposed to be doing the sterilization this side.
Yes.
Did you know that?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. And the complaint is that we send dogs there and they don't come back alive.
Yeah, I have actually seen that happen, which is why I actually discontinued going there very often. I still go there just for, you know, the well-being of animals, but I have seen a lot of negative feedback from people that, you know, it's not very negative, like it's really not nice and clean there. So I have put a word in for improvement to
who
the...
Who did you speak to?
To the owner of Blue Cross.
The trustee?
I'm not sure of his name, but...
Who, the person who works there?
Yeah.
So he's the manager?
The manager, basically, yeah.
Right.
So he said that they will try to improve the way they work, but I don't know.
Well, what we'll do is, we'll go there together and go live on Facebook over there and find out what's happening.
Sure, let's do that.
Yes?
Yeah, we do.
So we'll go meet Dr. Sabne and then we'll make we'll maybe invite Blue Cross to come there, the Blue Cross representative. I forget his name. Mr. Satish, is he? No.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I forget his name, but Shinde.
Shinde, yes.
Yes, Mr. Yes. Shinde, who is the manager, and it's being managed very badly.
Yeah.
So let's go there together.
We should go there.
And make sure that things get sorted out and the dogs here all get sterilized very fast.
Yes.
Yeah, so here is another one who's come to say hi to you.
That's
Jack, I guess. Jack? Okay.
That's one, she's Jack.
So, Wunsch has gone to play with another dog there, and look at this one. Oh, sweetie pie. Lovely. So we are going to also start the water bowl project. Yeah, that they just love affection. That is all that they want, isn't it?
Oh my God.
Yeah, that's okay.
You get scared.
Yeah, but he knows. He knows what to do. So
if he knows what to do.
If you transfer his fear to him, he will be held back. But just the fact
that you're the germs, I mean, they are dirty.
It's outside after all, and India sadly is dirty.
That's actually what I'm scared of, the gnats and the germs that they pass on.
You can always wash your hands. Yeah. What's water and soap there for?
That is it.
So he's just excited. And we are to start the water bowl project very soon here. Yeah, so I'll introduce you to Dhruv also. He's already doing this. And maybe we'll have water bowls a little ahead.
Yes.
Yeah, and we'll get in touch with Lakshman Moletti, who has started the animal water bowl project. So he's in Hyderabad, but we can start this project here as well.
Sure.
Yeah? Lovely meeting all of you.
Lovely meeting you, Auntie.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Munch
has gone off to play with that little dog over there. So, bye everyone.
Bye.